Oops. Where is the foundry under attack? In Meridian, okay. Hmm. God, and there's a threat to Angel Forge, though. God damn it. Oh, Day's left two on the other one, though, for the option.
Angel Forge is on Meridian, though.
Yeah, I know, but there's a threat to Angel Forge going on right now, is what it's saying.
Right.
All right, well, first things first. Power Fist! Power Fist! All right, that's out of the way. So, Guardian of Faith is a really good bolter for that. Is probably better than Purifier of Tombs.
Let me see. Guardian of Faith, 13.8 damage. Level 10. Oh, yeah. Suppression resistance, 45 health, plus 23 damage. What?
Seems pretty good.
And scatter damage. And we can melt down the normal bolter, or the normal plasma pistol, or whatever. M35 Magnacore type, special issue weapon, is slower firing than a bolter, but able to damage any target type, effective... Oh, okay, so that's the nice thing about plasma guns, is they do extra damage versus vehicles and buildings.
Yeah, yeah. It does help with that, but...
I reduce target armor for duration. Whereas, yeah, bolters are just your basic small arms. One thing I found is there's this show called Cops.
Raiment of Smoke.
Show Cops came out, so they had to rename it Cyber Cops.
Raiment of Smoke. Plus 62 health, plus 5% movement speed when hit by a melee weapon, 22% per hit to recover 40 health. Be like smoke. Stealing the enemy's sight and breath, but fading to nothingness when he strikes. From the lessons of Sergeant Cyrus to the Scouts of the Blood Ravens chapter. Well, that's cool if your fucking self is inscribed on a piece of legendary armor.
Yeah.
Why don't you wear it?
Let's see, plus 7% movement. Oh, I could probably switch Targus's armor, huh?
Yeah, let's look at what armors are available. It's a little dated, but...
Ugh.
Plus
9, let's see, we got... Man, none of these have particularly good bonuses.
No, but Mantle of Holy Fury is probably just a decent choice.
Yeah. Was you just talking? Yeah, was you just talking about the RPG where you don't change weapons constantly?
Yeah, it was Ark the Lad Twilight of Spirits, which I did like that idea of just that you basically had accessories for your weapons, which yeah. Like you could wrap shit around them or like things that would polish out the blade, etc., etc. And it basically was you're equipping a new weapon, but it did so in a kind of tasteful manner that I appreciated.
Yeah. When you first said that, when you first said, like, oh yeah, you don't change weapons constantly, I'm like, oh, okay, so they remove the equipment equation from, like, the grind. But it's like, oh no, they just
changed. No, it's just more of a lore piece, which I appreciate.
Yeah.
That
way they didn't have to change the models that much.
I mean, yeah, that's also an excuse, but... let's see, Yeah, I should probably just scrap all the jump packs and tackle relocators just because I'm not going to use them. I'll, like, say to myself, like, I'm going to use this. It'll be neat and cool. And then, like, no, I won't. I'm just going to leave on a force field.
The leader of cops is named Baldwin P. Bulletproof Vest. Fucking goddamn it.
Okay, I think we got our equipment in order again, and more importantly, I have a Power Fist now!
Nice.
Look at this doofy Force Command.
Yeah, the nice thing about Power Fists is how little sense they make.
It's the size of this pauldron.
So the main thing is that, like, it has to be that big because it's just a cylinder that has a giant power field generator in it. The rest of the it's a power field generator with a gauntlet built around it. And then Marnius Khalgar has even bigger power fists that are, like, comically large. Like, each power fist is the size of his entire body.
Remote detonation. That's sick. Whoa! That's ridiculous. Okay.
Or actually, it would be the size of... It's the size of, like, a normal Space Marine's torso, but of course he has special, venerated dread... Or not dreadnought armor. Venerated, Terminator armor. As the chapter master.
Okay, so I think we, because this thing says it's a threat to Angel Forge, we deal with that first, then we deal with the 2 days left thing, because that'll be 1 day left. Then we do Death Whisper, and then we go somewhere else.
Yeah.
Commander, chapter records do indeed make mention of this Idranel, which the Eldar Warlock mentioned. She is a Farseer, a witch leader of her people. And aligned with the same.
I don't know how, like, the threats to Angel Forge represents. Like, is it gonna, like, can we leave it for a day? How does it read that?
Might be happening immediately.
The Tyrian invasion
continues all about the sector, but this is our opportunity to put an end to the Eldar efforts to destabilize.
I'm ready to punch some vehicles.
Interweb?
What? Oh, you know, the interwebway gate.
Oh man, we're in Tyranid country now.
Best to move quickly. Every moment here gives the Tyranid infestation time to grow.
So let's see.
I feel like I move a lot slower now for some reason. Weapons
ready. So we captured the what did we capture last time?
Another Imperial Shrine, I think.
Yeah, so we need to capture the Foundry.
Well, the Power Fist looks real dumb when fighting, like, melee opponents, but when fighting big things, it looks real good.
Yeah.
When allies' forces are coming, allied infantry are dying. We must support them.
Devastator Marines ready for... You need me to form up with you?
Oh, no. Cyrus just lost A, dude. He's fine. Ah, fuck. Okay. We're okay. Redeploy to defensive. That was almost very, very bad, but we're okay.
Tactical Marine.
years.
No worries, I heard you freaking out.
Of course, even Rosarius doesn't protect me against sword bitches.
You know, maybe you should get
the main problem from them is they have all the fucking knockback.
You know, maybe you should get an assault
no,
marine.
Fuck
help you.
Fuck you, I'm throwing down a tarantula turret in this fight.
Oh, Tarkus.
Oh man, they killed Tarkus inside the building.
It happens.
Oh, because they have a tank. That's what's going on.
There, Tarkus up.
Ah, he's down again.
Oh no.
I even told him to retreat as soon as he was alive.
Yeah.
So the next health level he's getting, he'll be invincible for a couple seconds after he gets brought back. Oh, there's an actual tank back there, I think is what's up.
Back where?
There's an actual tank down the street that I can't see. Of heretics.
That's a pretty good name.
So it turns out that this particular heavy bolter has the knockback is actually causing.
Oh, of course, Commander fell. I looked away because I was busy focusing on some accessories from Cyrus. I'm not good at micro. I will never claim to be good at micro. I enjoy this game, but I'm awful at micro.
Oh,
Luckily, other than, like, somewhat penalizing you on that day count because the game's rude to begin with, there's not really anything lost by, as long as you manage to successfully clear the map.
That was actually a pretty good bait. Okay, there's the thing. Alright, I got a command point. And a melted bomb. Okay, there was the thing. It wasn't an actual tank, it was just... It was another one of those, like, floating weapons platforms that just had a, like, a heavy assault thing. Oh, but that's a real tank.
Oh, jeez.
A bomb. Fortunately, they're attacking me right where I have. Wasn't they attacking me right next to the That said, it is, like, inconvenient, incredibly, getting hit by this.
Yeah, I get it.
Alright, that tank's almost toast. It's gone.
Get to that position, brothers. Cyrus's boys do not right-click for very hard anymore. For some reason. Trying to go pick up the Force Commander, but there's just too many dudes in the way.
Oh shit, okay. So the thing that sucks when you run out of grenades and you're trying to grenade somebody and it's not that you don't realize that it happened is that you click on an enemy and then you can't control your dudes anymore.
Yeah. I've encountered that a number of times.
Shit,
it didn't see me. How did it hit me?
Don't run in there. What the fuck are you doing? Attack it from the other side, you dumbass. I told my tactical marines to go throw a grenade at a tower that they could clearly see, and their decision was to run around a fucking wall into an enemy encampment.
I don't really get my unit's path of retreat. Oh, okay, that's why they were going this way.
Pasta squad eliminated. Yeah, pasta squad eliminated. This way, brothers. Oh shit, he can just walk through that, huh?
Huh?
Oh, I just...
Oh, you're fighting a Wraith Lord!
Yeah, that happened. Can you guys not, like, okay, fucking target, what are you doing? Back to next position. Where's your guys', like, shooting position? Like, what is your angle of fire there? Brothers, Jesus. We go.
Okay, I'm picking up support items because I figure you could use them too at this point in time.
Yeah, I need some. I need kind of a shit ton of melta bombs. Back.
Okay, can you do me a favor and look up here for just a moment?
Where's up here?
Never mind. I just wanted you to see the glorious explosion that was about to happen. It's too late. Don't worry about it. Figuring shit out one bit at a time.
Alright, I've got the I'm hearing the foundry. I call it. Alright, I'm gonna get the foundry.
Okay.
Okay, wait, hold on. I got another squad of fuckers I gotta take down. Are you guys gonna like shoot anything?
Good. I hate Zenos too. Feed me more. Yeah, I could probably use them.
Alright. There you go.
Thank you. No, that should be good for now.
Alright, I'm about to take the foundry.
If you need to, go ahead and get more, but...
Nah, I got 4 melted bombs, I'm good.
Field generators are deploying now, Commander. Additional generators will not be available until your next deployment.
Okay, there's more of them sword chicks.
You know.
No, fuck you.
You get out of range if you had a jump pack.
I think what I'm gonna do is deploy a tarantula turret right here and some devastators. And I'll just bait them in. Just draw them into an unstoppable field of fire once they inevitably jump on my dudes.
Once they inevitably get on your dick.
The bitches they are. Okay, get down.
I could
get down.
Use...
Get down, girl. Go ahead, get down.
Go ahead, get down. I could use a supply item if you have one.
Yeah, one sec. Alright, you good?
Thank you. Yeah, I just needed that to take out one of their psychers.
Alright, I'm nearing the final objective. You want me to join
I
up
probably
with you?
Will be shortly. If you'd like. won't take too much longer.
Alright. This is how it is. Because, yeah, I'm, like, right next to the arena.
At your command.
Repositioning. I'll just leave Avidus near the front of the arena.
Tactical squad repositioning.
Because I don't know where the fight trigger starts.
Mm-hmm. It's gonna be clean enough. You know, clean as I purge everything. Oh, never mind. That's a Wraith Lord.
I got no bumps.
Oh, right. I stun vehicles with my power fist. Get fucked. Fucked into the next dimension.
Get fucked to death by Slaanesh.
You fucked her into this world and she'll fuck you out of it.
Moving to that position.
I wanna kill this guy as long as I'm... Let's go deal with an objective.
This is Avitus. Set up firing position in there. How can we serve? Repositioning.
I need to switch off this force field for a moment so I start regenerating energy again.
There's probably going to be a Psyker-heavy battle, I'm imagining.
How can we serve? Time to redeploy. Set up firing position in there.
Yeah, I presume so. It seemed like a name Psyker was the main bud.
Tactical squad repositioning.
Where is she?
I don't know. I'm gonna take the moment to run over this crate that I can't auto-attack
there
or something.
She is.
Oh, there she is.
Target in sight.
I have foreseen all your intended, but I will not allow you to bring ruination upon us.
She summons the powers of the warp itself.
Heading out. Orders for us. Tactical squad. Eliminate the enemy on target. With me, brothers, advance.
She is just like weirdly durable. Like, she's not even all that threatening. She does damage, but it's not like she burst kills people.
Grenade that target.
Oh, that actually did hurt you though.
Yeah. Psyker abilities are rough.
Turns out the Force Commander can still just knock her over like an idiot though.
Keep your distance.
Keep my distance? That doesn't sound like a thing the Force Commander would do. And I am doing nothing if not a roleplay build. Oh, I can just fucking stun her like an idiot.
That hurt.
Eliminate those Eldar before the grenade.
Turns out the combo works on bosses too.
God damn it, I just burned my frag grenade. This would have been a good time for it to happen.
That's alright.
Kill them all. Her shield is down. Strike before it can recharge.
I don't even see where she is.
I'm hitting one of her.
Ah, there she is. Oh, jeez!
I have other tasks to attend to on this doomed planet.
She's escaping!
Whatever.
I admit I have enjoyed this dalliance, humans. I may even miss you when you are ash and cinders.
Bitch, we just whooped your ass!
Cinders. Tyranids drain worlds of life. They do not burn them.
Yeah, Tyranids wouldn't.
I mean, that seems like a false check mark.
That's
just impractical. No biomass to get.
Yeah. Can't make Tyranids out of ash. There we go. We did get that bonus for forges, though. Aw.
Blinding
well, once we
revelation
sell off
plasma
gear, we'll...
pistol. Ooh.
Once we saw some gear, then Tarkus and Avidus will level.
The alien witch escaped! She laughs at us while our worlds die!
God, Avidus is such an angry
sure
man.
Sergeant's frustration, but I have far graver news. I have finally obtained the master control codes for Angel Forge and have transmitted them to your ship and
yeah,
to Captain Angelo's fleet.
It's like
I fear it may be too late to do you any good, however.
No
another
worries.
Tyranid swarm is driving into the Forge area. Massive defensive walls guard the approach to the forge, but the Imperial Guard forces stationed there are being overrun.
Your delaying and politicking has doomed us all, DeRosa.
If so, I'm sure my end will be suitably horrific, Sergeant.
Suitably horrific is a pretty good one.
The same of Governor Vandis.
What do you mean?
He probably departed the planet.
I make no excuses for my mistakes, but I have been fighting to get those codes for you for days. The Governor simply ordered me to continue delaying you. And then stopped answering me altogether. When I finally dealt with the House Vandis soldiers guarding his residence, I found he had left the Meridian system
yeah,
for some private retreat three sectors away. I did find
that's such
hobbled.
Like, here's the thing.
You took a real risk.
That's fine. I get him leaving. Why did he not want to share the codes that would give us the thing to help save
the
place? The
entire sector to die. Your commander
like that's
is here,
ridiculous.
Fighting to save it.
Yeah, no. That's
if anything,
like,
I was
especially
far too
in worlds
slow to
like
see
this,
where my loyalties
what
belonged.
Like that, that's kind of the story.
Well, like,
in
it's a zero net game. It doesn't lose anything by giving us the codes and leaving.
Yeah, I don't know. Oh, hey, Avidus is leveled up. All right, we'll finish getting experience and leveling up.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because I can get now. Avidus is in focus fire. He doesn't take knockback. Which is good, because that means I can use it again. Ooh, man. Orc killer. Let's see. What's this one? Gain cover from whatever. He took out occurrence on the planet. I think it might be the thing that he was just trying to delay his escape. Or he was trying to delay the news that he had escaped. That's just sort of a thing that planetary governors do in the face of Tyranids because they're pieces of shit.
I don't know. It just seems incredibly excessive.
Yeah, that's 40k.
That's fair.
That's Dallas. Alright, if you can get me another 13 experience, then Tarkus can get a range specialist. Which admittedly
almost
doesn't matter too much at the moment. Because we don't have a good flame weapon or plasma weapon that's better than the current stuff we have. But it'll be good to have. And then I'll start dumping stuff back in HP. Wait, what's tactical advance? Oh, that's his other specialty, right? So, Tarkus's last ability is I Shall Not Fall. As long as tactical advance is active, Tarkus fights through the worst of injuries and cannot be incapacitated.
That's weird. Okay. That's interesting. That seems good.
So
weird.
One of the things, like, that's the thing, is Tarkus gets a bunch of abilities that just prevent him from dying. So, like, Lariman's Blessing. After being revived in combat, Tarkus cannot be harmed for several seconds. So he can't fall again like happened in the last encounter. Shield of the Righteousness, 80 plus 80 health plus 2% sight range. And armor rating of 28. What's your current power armor? Because Glory of Mateel is plus 3 melee skill and plus 64 energy.
Yeah, I keep looking at it, and it looks nice, but on the other hand, my current one is slightly less armor, but it's plus 42 health and plus 9% melee damage.
So, plus 3 melee skill would improve your melee damage, and plus 64 energy would improve Iron Halo.
No. Melee skill is the chance to perform special melee attacks, it's not trait strength.
Okay.
It'd be strength, that's the thing.
Sure.
The energy does seem nice. And I am considering it, just...
Oh, ha. Mm. If I, for some reason, dump more points into Avidus's melee skill, he gets a knockout blow, apparently.
To just smack an idiot?
Yeah, swing-equipped weapon in a wide arc, knocking enemies near...
That's not terrible, actually. The clear out? Yeah.
Maybe once I hit the next level of range ability, because let's see.
Oh no, his focus is probably better, it's just that it's not awful.
Well, more what okay, I'm saying. So accurate from cover, heavy weapon specialty. He no longer needs to... Oh, wow. So the last one that...
That's really good.
Yeah, he doesn't need to set up, he can just go.
Shoot idiots forever. Let's see. Trade that in.
And then also the last health ability he gets is just when in cover, immune from knockback, except from certain special abilities. But yeah, maybe dumping into ranged attack is a better call here.
Than what?
Than melee. Just try to match.
Oh yeah,
that
yeah,
out.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I probably should have dumped in the ranged attack early. We misunderstood what Terminator Honors was.
I don't think it's that big of a problem. It didn't, like, destroy our run or anything.
Nah, it's just not as good as it could.
Plus, keeping him alive is great, so I don't have an issue.
And I guess also, once I max out that, then investing in Will would be good, because then I can hold Focus Fire for longer and eventually get another equipment slot.
So I think everyone has leveled up this time around, so yeah, there's not extra experience to be gained.
Yeah, no, Avidus' next level's in 700 XP. Tarkus is similar.
Alright, so we're definitely doing Defend the Foundry next when we come back.
Yeah. Note that down.
Because that'll last one day.
I like that we keep getting Dreadnought plating.
Yeah, it seems weird they did it this early. I don't know if we could have, what's his name by now?
I mean, it's also how we found the better missile launcher than the first one we're supposed to get. And then also,
I don't think we found that one. I think it was just in my inventory for some reason.
And then also there was that mission where we learned how to use tarantula turrets, even though we had already been using
them. That one was really weird. Well, not only that we had been using him for a while, but that particular, F1 drop-in we'd had during that one defense mission, which we had to do.
Yeah. So, if we got the F1 drop, And then it taught us about capturing extra buildings so that it becomes its own ability. That would have made sense. But yeah, I'm happy with Tarkus as a system by which to deliver infinite grenades.
Yeah, no, being a grenade wizard is a really powerful thing.
Also, wow, man, Tarkus can't equip power swords unless you max out melee specialty.
Why would you want to? I guess he's got these weird, like, durability things going on, but, like, even then, like, just take a range player.
You know, I have not been using Tactical Advance. I probably should. Like, although it seems like he just moves in suppression state. Like, that's kind of the thing, is you break suppression and reduce incoming range damage at the cost of movement speed. Like, I guess I haven't done it, so I don't know how it is. I just didn't do it because I didn't like moving slower. But it might explain why Tarkus keeps dying a lot. We also have just a generic missile launcher, but it does do a lot of damage. It shoots a bunch of crack missiles.
Oh, yeah. Those are just generally pretty solid. Let's see. Where's the thing I'm looking for?
Gauntlet of the Ancients. Warriors entombed within venerable dreadnoughts are truly ancient, having served beyond death for thousands of years. To ease the pain of so many years, the venerable warriors often allowed centuries of slumber before being called to take the field of battle for the chapter. I mean, that's just the thing. That is one of the, I think I had said it before, but in Deathwatch, you can become a dreadnought if certain things apply.
Okay, so I just spoiled myself by looking things up, but I really don't give a shit. When we finish doing the defensive Angel Forge bullshit, that's when we get Terminator armor.
Right, because Angel Forge is what makes Terminator suits, I think.
And when we get the Prime Gene samples, we get our good Dreadnought boy.
Gotcha. So yeah, we'll finish up Angel Forge and then the Terminator honors that I unlocked can finally be used.
Yeah, I also got the Terminator armor on Thaddeus now, so.
Whenever we end up using him, ever.
We won't, but it's nice to know that he has them.
It's also weird that the Force Commander doesn't get Terminator armor.
Yeah, it seems a bit odd.
He does get everything else.
He's a natural pig.
I wonder if he just automatically has Terminator honors.
That might be a thing, I wonder. Let's check.
Because, yeah, it would seem weird.
Yes, apparently.
Yeah, because he's a commander, so yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it makes sense. He already gets tons of crazy bullshit. Like, he can get the warp packs already, or the jump jets, and
Iron halos. Yeah.
That makes him unkillable as long as I'm not an idiot and stop paying attention to him. Oh, geez, I did not realize that was a thing. Okay, that's part of why he's utterly insane, among other things.
What?
So I put points into his energy skill a little bit, because it is relevant on him. He gets some good shit. But I put it up to the first ability, which is Commander's Loadout, which adds an extra accessory slot. And that's all I assumed it was, because I built up to it because it looked like that image.
Oh.
Except it also adds that if he ever kills an enemy, he regains energy.
Right. So that's why you
because
can just
he's
throw
just
him into
terrifying.
This way you could just throw him into a fight and let him go forever.
God, like if it wasn't for the fact that there was did you unequip my pistol?
Yeah, my finger slipped.
Ah, okay. No worries. But Yeah, if I, If the Rosarius was not so fucking useful that we needed to take it, I kind of want to give him just, like, frag grenades so that he could just blow up a huge field of men and regain all his energy. In fact, fuck cluster mines. They haven't even been useful yet. I've tried it. They suck. Rosarius and Cyrus. Thaddeus, give me those frag grenades. There we go.
Those nice mastercrafted frag grenades.
No, you only are. You're Tark is the only one who knows how to use mastercrafted frag grenades.
Yeah, right.
With his bomb wizardry.
It's so good. I've never run out of energy on Tarkus.
I told you! It's the best thing you can get! Like, of all of the abilities that everyone gets, that's the best one.
Yeah, because it just kills shit. Like, it's why it works so well with a Devastator squad, because Devastators will suppress enemies so they can't move, so they can't run in and dump bombs on them.
Alright, but I will definitely agree with the sentiment. That's it for now. So let's save and exit to Windows.
Yeah.
That file is now saved in place.
Cool. All right.
So yeah, the thing after this is the Chaos Rising, which is the same characters, because if we don't fuck up, we win. How about that?
I'm guessing we're fighting the forces of Chaos in that one.
Yeah, like, exactly. We're fighting Chaos. There's even more levels past what is shown here for getting abilities and things. More interesting items. There's this weird corruption mechanic that is kind of cool, but I have mixed feelings on it. But then the separate standalone thing, that is, I guess it's still an expansion, but separate standalone, is... I forget the name of it. I have it. One sec. Retribution. And Retribution, in addition to having like interesting survival modes and a bunch of stuff, has modes where you play as a bunch of different groups,
yeah,
not just space.
Isn't that the one where there's the orc plot that they want to get a hat?
Fuck yeah, there is. They want an Inquisitor's hat, and an Inquisitor that's trying to get them to do things, and they're just like, yeah, whatever, we'll pretend to do those things, but really I'm going to murder her and take her hat.
Yeah, I remember that.
And more importantly, that their version of Cyrus is named Spookum. Spookums. Let's see, yeah. Retribution adds Eldar, Space Marine, Chaos, the Orcs, and Tyranids. A Tyranid mission? Fuck yeah.
What? A mission as Tyranids?
Yeah. Fucking Tyranid campaign.
I want to know what the fucking Tyranid mission briefing is. It's just, I want to think it's just consume. Consume. Consume.
So apparently it's mostly the same story, but you play as different things depending on what you pick.
Sure.
Yeah, let's see. Chaos. Consume. Oh, it has Eliphas from other things. Eldar. Imperial Guard. I'm just rather there's an Tau one, but...
Yeah, there aren't Tau in the current game, so it makes sense.
Captain Blood Flag.
Yeah, they're real good. I love the Free Buddhas. Alright, I'm gonna stop recording now too.